Unique in a week. In this series, I'm killing certain monsters to get a unique drop only that monster has, or do some kind of activity to achieve a certain goal. The time limit is 1 week. If I fail to do the challenge, I'm going to do punishment tasks that may include only doing runecrafting, agility, or maybe picking flax. The best part is that you, the viewer, actually control what challenges and punishment tasks for failing I will do. In this video, I'm going over what uniques I need to get, what are the stakes, I mean punishment tasks, what kind of gear I used and why, and of course, the loot I got. And in the end, a sprinkle of my opinion on why this camping challenge is good or bad. Because this is the first episode, I'm lucky enough to choose what I will do this time. So this time, I'm camping Kurasks. When we are looking at Kurasks' drop table, the only unique items these monsters have are actually Leafblade Sword, Battle Axe, and Kurasks' Head. So this is our goal to achieve for this challenge. What are the tasks if I actually fail? For this episode, if I fail, I'm gonna do runecrafting for 4 hours, or I'm gonna punch cows for equal amount of time. That already sounds like a fun on Hardcore Iron Man, but it takes damn a lot of skill to fail this one. When I started this challenge, you saw me getting Kurask task, so first 140 Kurasks or so will be done with my range setup here. This is what I would normally use when I'm on a Slayer task. Later I actually switched to this gear for actually camping Kurasks without a Slayer task. I calculated DPS on this website, link down in the description, to see if it's better than my Slayer gear, and it was. More DPS as you can see. As for other items, I would recommend bringing runes for a high alchemy, Bone Crusher if you have that, bring it for extra prayer experience, and Herb Sack, which decreases the times you have to go to the bank. How good were the drops? You may notice I got a lot of coins. Kurasks are great because they drop a lot of stackable items, so you don't need to bank that often. And yes, this time I managed to complete the challenge and I got 2 out of 3 items I was aiming for. In total, without adding the herbs, I got it up to 1.8 million GP for the loot. I wasn't counting my nature runes, but you get quite a number of those. Let's add the herbs and we got like 2.1 million GP in total. I'm quite happy with this one because of the seed drops I can use later. So for Iron Man out there, definitely a thumbs up from me. And some thoughts from Rusty Teapot now. All in all, I can say, this was a very relaxing challenge. I remember being tired and still enjoying this one to the fullest. I wouldn't consider this the most efficient hour spent, but damn, YouTube plus this works wonders. And I say, if you like chill environment, plus getting some herbs, seeds and stuff you can elk, this is a place for you. As for Iron Man, just do it, my dudes. Don't forget to vote for the next episode challenge, and see you next time!